Welcome to Back to Bethel.
Woohoo! Am I the only one excited here this morning?
It's Christmas. Amen. Time to celebrate Jesus' birthday. Man, doesn't get any better than that, does it? Not till Easter. Amen. Next Sunday is our Christmas dinner here, 6 o'clock at the Miracle Center. The church will provide turkey, ham, and fried chicken. If you will bring sides to go with that and some good fattening desserts like we need it. And we're going to do something new this year. We're going to do a Chinese gift exchange at the Christmas party. So if you want to participate, you don't have to, but if you want to, adults bring a gift valued at $10 to $20, wrapped. And it needs to be either for a man or a woman, so you'll probably need to mark it in some way. When I've done Chinese Christmas, we didn't do that, but for a man or a woman. Okay, all right, that makes more sense.
I could use a new hairbrush.
Ponytail ties, that's what he needs. And if you want your kids to participate, bring something again that a boy or a girl could use, $5 to $10 in value. Okay? We'll do that this year and see how that goes. That'll be fun. Amen? It's that time of year when we're all preparing for the big day, right? You're shopping, decorating, wrapping presents. What are you doing to prepare yourself for that day? What are you doing for you to make sure that you're where you need to be and that you're ready? There are things we can do to make sure that we receive the greatest gift that has ever existed. In our carnal flesh, we're not worthy. We're not. So what do you do? What do you do? You need to pray. You need to pray a lot. And you need to spend some private time reflecting. Think about life. Think about where you've been. Think about where you are. And you need to think about where you're going. Think about the things in your life that have made you who you are. What gave you the scars? What put the joy in your heart? What gave you peace and comfort? Think on those things. Listen to some good music. I love Christmas music. But if you're not into good Christmas music, listen to some good gospel music. You know, when you're down and out, when you think you can't take another step, when you don't know how you're going to bear the burdens, where the money's going to come from, all the things that we carry with us, put on a good song and just get into it. Melt into the music. And you'll find But you won't be thinking about that bill that's going to be due on January 5th. It won't matter. God will take care of it on January 4th. Amen. Amen. Enjoy your music. And the last thing you can do this time of year is do something good for somebody. That doesn't mean you have to go out and spend a lot of money on them. That's not what I'm talking about. Love them. Let somebody see the love of Jesus through what you do for them. Christmas is all about love. If he didn't love us, do you think he would have gone through that? If there had been another way, he did what he had to do. It was his choice. But do something good for somebody. Try to mend a bridge if you've got one in your life with someone that you haven't talked to in years for whatever reason. Pick up that phone and call them. Or send them a card. And sign it love. Love in Christ. There are things we can do during this season that don't cost a penny. That can prepare us and help us to be ready to accept the greatest gift in the world. And I hope you spend some time thinking on those things. It's important. I love you guys. Come on. Remember our sick folks this morning, please. We have some people who definitely need your prayers. Please remember all of them. Our gracious Heavenly Father, God, we thank you so much for this season, for that precious baby, for Mary and Joseph and what they did for us. God, we love you so much. God, we pray for each and every family that's represented here today. God, any needs that there are, whatever they are, God, I pray that you hear the cries of these hearts today. God, wrap your arms around the families. Bring them close together to each other and to you, Lord. God, show them the love that they may show each other. Strengthen them. God, we love you. We need you so much. Heavenly Father, we ask for your Holy Spirit to move among us today, to touch each and every person. God, we ask for you to watch over those of our brothers and sisters, God, who have physical needs today. We have some who are sick, facing surgeries. God, we ask for you to wrap your arms, comfort, peace, and joy around them today. God, let them feel your presence. Let them know that you're mighty and in control, and it's all going to be okay. God, we ask for you to bless this offering to the upkeep of your kingdom. Bless the singers as they lead us in praise and worship today. Jeremy, as he presents the word and the message that you've laid on his heart. Thank you, God, for all of your blessings, seen and unseen. Be with us in our service, Lord. And we will praise you. We will honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Stand up and praise God today.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. And the mansion bright and blessed will prepare for us a place when we all get to heaven. What a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of heaven and glory will the toll of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Turn around and welcome 5 people this morning. The Christ before us, soon his beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we will tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of the ghost that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Preacher, I don't like shaking hands in church. Do you go to Walmart and put your hands on a shopping cart? If you don't wash that shopping cart, then guess what? Shake somebody's hand.
It was almost Christmas time, and there I stood in another line, trying to buy that last gift or two. Not really in the Christmas mood. And standing right in front of me, a little boy waited anxiously, pacing around like little boys do. And in his hands he held a pair of shoes. And his clothes were worn and torn. They were dirty from head to toe. And when it came his time to pay, I couldn't believe what I heard him say. I want to buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. She's been sick for quite a while. I know these shoes would make her smile, and I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. He counted pennies for what seemed like years, and the cashier said, son, there's not enough here. He searched his pockets frantically, and then he turned and he looked at me. He said, Mama made Christmas good at her house, though most years she just did without. Tell me, sir, what am I gonna do? Somehow I've gotta buy her these Christmas shoes. So I laid the money down. I just had to help him out. I'll never forget the look on his face when he said, Mama's gonna look so great. Sir, I wanna buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve, and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. She's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes would make her smile, and I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. I knew I'd caught a glimpse of heaven's love as he thanked me and ran out. I knew that God had sent that little boy to remind me what Christmas is all about. Sir, I want to buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. She's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes would make her smile, and I want her to look beautiful. Mama meets Jesus tonight. I want her to look beautiful. Mama meets Jesus precious friends family, and the place of peace is waiting up above. Hold my hand and stay there by my side, and when I finally step into the tide, celebrate me home, celebrate me. Celebrate me in that land of wonder where nothing can compare. Celebrate me in that place. Celebrate me, save my grace. Don't you sit and weep because I'm gone. Celebrate me home. I've spent more of my life on earth preparing to take this trip from here to heaven's shore, with the shield and the word of God to guide me. It's a comfort knowing I am not alone. So when I take my final fleeting breath and fade into the gentle sleep of death, celebrate me home, celebrate me there, celebrate me in that land of wonder where nothing can compare. Celebrate me in that place.
metaphor that kind of goes with the message, although I'm not preaching next. Y'all remember what this song right here says.
Now there are those who said that I'd surely fall when I told them I'd given Jesus my all. And I guess I really can't blame them for having their doubts. Oh, for they only know what I used to be. But oh, what a difference the Lord has made in me. What I got was real. Praise God, I'm still serving Him now. And I'm forever changed. I'm forever changed. All things are brand new. I tell you it's true, 'cause I'm not the same. Change my eternal destiny. All things passed away. I thank God for the day my forever changed. Now if this life was all that He promised to me, friends, I'd still choose to serve the Lord faithfully. But I can begin to imagine what He has in store. Oh, for once I was lost, I was headed for hell, but then I got saved. Now all things are well. My forever began when I took the precious hand of Jesus, my Lord. And I'm forever changed. I'm forever changed. All things are brand new. I tell you. Thank God for the day my forever changed. Oh, for He changed the heart of me. Oh, He changed my eternal destiny. Oh, things passed away. I thank God for the day my forever
change. Boy, that high note's hard to hit in the midst of cold and flu season. Hello, somebody. Come on, Brother Michael. Sing this morning. Brother Jerry, you'll follow him right up.
God, I'm so glad for Calvary. A flat. Well, years I spent in agony. Let's try the stupid key. I'm sorry. You have always had to change for some reason. Well, years I spent in vanity and pride, For knowing not my Lord was crucified, not for me, it was for him. He died at Calvary. For mercy there was grace, and grace was free. For pardon there was multiplied to me. Well, there my burden so profoundly hurt at Calvary. By God's word, at last my sins I burned. Then I trembled at the law I spurned. Here my guilty soul did grow and turn to Calvary. Mercy there was grace, and grace was free. We'll pardon there for the pride to me. And there my burden so found liberty at Calvary. Oh, the love that drew salvation plan. Oh, the grace that brought it down to man. Oh, the mighty love that God did spend at Calvary. Mercy there was grace, and grace was free. Pardon there would multiply to me. There my burden so found liberty at Calvary. God bless you. Thank you much.
Well, God was good to us. I tell you, we got a great church, great Sunday school classes, great teachers, great people. The heartbeat of this church starts in that Sunday school. I really believe that. I can't express how blessed we are.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you or evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood.
Well, there's power, power,
wonder working power in the blood. Land. And there's fire, fire, wonder.
I don't know if you've ever seen somebody do that before. I flung them out in the audience. Don't mean to. I tell you, I'm so tired today, but I had such a wonderful time last night. I think we ate too much. Mm-hmm. I don't know what y'all think, but I'm just overwhelmed. I talked about that last night. Just, as you would say, meekness, gentleness, and loving me. There's a lot of gifts in there. I don't think some people have realized they got. I really see a lot of us growing, and some growing in different directions than others. I see some great things coming out of here. Don't know when, but it's coming. I can assure you that. Ready?
Well, God is good. Yes, He is. He's good all the time. God is good, no He is, He's good all the time. You can search the whole world over, no greater friend you'll find. He's not good just once in a while, He's good all the time. God is good, yes He is, He's good all the time. God is good, no He is, He's good all the time. You can search this whole world over, no greater friend you'll find. He's not good just once in a while, He's good all the time. Now we've all had friends that let us down, know what I'm talking about. At the very first sign of trouble, they're nowhere to be found. Well, Jesus stays when others go, He'll never leave your side. He's your friend in stormy weather, 'cause He's good all the time. God is good, yes He is, He's good all the time. God is good, no He is, 'cause He's good all the time. You can search this whole world over, no greater friend will find. He's not good just once in a while, He's good all the time. He's the one that we call at night when our body moans in pain. Don't worry about that wayward child, He heard you call His name. He'll put food in your kitchen, hoping you didn't have a dime. He's not good just now and then, He's good all the time. Well, now God is good, yes He is,
church this whole world over. There's no greater friend we'll find. He's not good just once in a while, 'cause he's good all the time.
Amen. I didn't know what to sing this morning until we got here, and there was somebody talking about power in the blood, and then in the Sunday school room there was prayer done, and this song, as the middle of the prayer was going, this was laid on my heart. So this is for that certain person. I have dreamed through the long dark night, out on the open sea. By faith alone, me, the anchor holds, though the ship is battered, the anchor holds, though the sails are torn. But the anchor holds, in spite of the storm. Thank you. though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Though the sails are torn,
I have fallen on my knees as I cross this broken chain. The anchor holds. It's find a store. I have fallen on my knees as I face my breaking sea. But the anchor holds. In spite of your soul.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness.
It's just
of
me,
a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch.
I bet you didn't know that it was just me, right? So what in the world are you going to preach on today with a Grinch head? Well, I'm glad you asked that question. I'll come to see who come to steal whose blessings today. The Grinch stole Christmas. Whose blessings are you stealing? Hello, somebody. Yesterday in downtown Paging, we had an event, and the Chamber of Commerce put it on, and they wanted to bring Whoville to life. And it was fun. It was lots of fun. I worked all day yesterday. I got home just in time to change clothes and report to the fire station for detail for standby. And we rode in the parade, one thing and another. They were bunches of Grinches running around down there. They even had a Grinch dance off, y'all. I didn't enter that contest because I didn't want to embarrass everybody else. And so I later found out that there was some controversy because the Chamber of Commerce was said to have been the coercer of evil by trying to remove Christ from Christmas by bringing the Grinch in and taking Jesus out. But that's really not what had happened. You see, if we have ever really sit and watch the movie The Grinch, we can find God in it. And y'all might be saying, y'all must have watched a different episode than what I watched, because I ain't never seen God in The Grinch. I'm here to tell you that if you really look, you can find Jesus under a rock. Hello, somebody. Everything that we do, we can find God in it. Amen? And if you can't find God in it, then do something else. Amen? So I want us to look at The Grinch today. Let's turn in our Bibles to Ephesians chapter 2, verses 1 through 6. Now, here's what it says in the King James Bible. And you, look at your neighbor and say, you. Now, look at your other neighbor and say, you. Now, I want you to point that finger back at yourself and say, me. You hath he quickened who were dead in trespasses and sins. If that don't sound Grinchy, I don't know what does. Grinch was just a normal little boy, amen? A short feller, hello somebody. He might have been green and hairy, but he was a normal child in the town of Whoville. He just got misplaced by the stork, hello somebody. And so he grew up in a loving and a nurturing home. Do you remember the movie that I'm telling you about? Say amen if you follow me this morning. He grew up in a loving and a nurturing home, but it was after he was sent out to public school that he began to be made fun of, and people ridiculed him, and they criticized him, they made fun of him, and they made jokes about him. And so because of all those things, that's what made the Grinch change his personality. Hello? I can stand here today and I can testify with my hand up that the world will make you bitter and cold if you allow that to happen. If we don't guard our minds like we guard our wallets, as Pastor Sonny would say, then we would allow the world to just slice and dice and Perrier us and cut us to pieces, and they would make us bitter and cold in our lifetime. We all have encountered things in our life that have hurt us to our very heart. They've cut us to the quick. They've tore us apart. And because of that, a lot of us have become bitter instead of better. I'm preaching to somebody here beside myself today. I stand before you and I do profess to be a Christian. I am the pastor of this church. But listen, there are some people in this world that if I allowed them to get on my nerves the way that they try to, I would rip their stinking head off. Hello, somebody. And you might be sitting there saying, preacher, hey, yeah, only because I'm saying it because you ain't up here. You'd be saying the same thing. We can allow people to make us bitter in our life. We will die in trespasses and sins. Verse 2. Wherein in time past you walked according to the course of this world. That means that we walked as a sinner through this world. We were part of this world. We were born of the flesh. We were overcome by the flesh. We were sinners. And we stood will be today unless it had been for the grace of God. Had it not been for the grace of God and the blood of Jesus, we would still be dead in the trespasses of our sin. But thankful to God and the Holy Spirit that convicted us in our lifetime and drew us to an altar of repentance and allow us to confess our sins and to ask the Lord Jesus Christ to wash away all the sins of our life, to come into our heart and make us be born again. We all walked in the flesh. We've all dealt in the flesh. We've lived in the flesh, and sometimes we still, as a Christian, have fleshly moments. Say amen. According to the prince of the power of the air, who is that? That is Satan. The spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. My, verse 3. Among whom also we all had our conversation in times past in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. Ain't nothing special about you. Hello, somebody. Nothing special about any of us except the grace of God. But God. Aren't you glad that your story changed at some point in time in your life? We fit the profile of those first three verses of Scripture of ones that were disobedient and unruly, people that had our own way of thinking, people that lived after the desires of the flesh. But God, But God saw fit to send His Son to a cross. For He who so loved the world gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe in Him would not perish, but have everlasting life. But God, who is rich in mercy, hallelujah, for His great love. What is Christmas about? Miss Debbie said this morning, it is all about love. If Christmas is about Jesus, then it is about love. Wherewith He loved us. Even, come on, look at your neighbor and say, even. Even when we were dead in sins. You mean to tell me that when I came to an altar with a life full of sin and evil doings and all of these attractions that I submitted to and all these addictions that I had in my life, even all the faults and the shame and the reproach that I brought Him, even in that lifestyle, He loved me? Oh yeah, He loved you before the creation of the earth. Even when we were dead in our sins, He has quickened us together with Christ. By grace, ye are saved. Ooh, that's good stuff. And hath raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Amen. Why do I need to go to church? Because we're supposed to be sitting together in heavenly places. Yeah, you can sit at home and watch it by way of Facebook, but you don't get the full effect of coming together and sitting in heavenly places in the presence of the Most High God. You don't get the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. Amen. Y'all can be seated. Amen. I appreciate the standing. Heather, if you would bring me a water and my towel from my bag, I appreciate it. So we look at Little Grinch here today, how the world turned him bitter and cold. And most of us, at some point in time of our life, have gone through a situation of some sort that has made us bitter instead of better. Do you know today, church, that your bitterness will block your blessings? I've been there. I can stand. I wrote the book on it. I've even got a t-shirt about it that tells me that your bitterness will block your blessings. But when you are able to forgive others, as God has even forgiven you, then you will be able to put that bitterness to bed, amen, and wake up a better person. You who were quickened, God quickened you. He called you. He repurposed you. He anointed you. He's appointed you. He's allowed you to be who you are, sitting together in heavenly places. Got a tickle in my throat. It's not funny. Don't make me laugh. There's not a one of us in this church today that have never been bitter about something in our life. And God didn't make you bitter. But so many times we take our wrath on Him. Well, so-and-so parked in my parking place out there this morning. Let me tell you something. If you want to park in a the spot, you just pull your little Volkswagen up in there, amen, and you park there and you have a good time with it. I'm not going to get upset because somebody parked in my parking spot, and I'm not going to come into church with my butt on my shoulders. Hello, somebody. I'm just going to go ahead and tell you how it is. I'm going to leave my burdens hanging out on the burden bushes this morning, and I'm going to come in to the house of God with my mind set on Him and heavenly places and the blessings that He bestowed upon me. I'm not going to let no Grinch steal my lesson this morning. I come in here to get what God has in store for me, and I'm going to get it. I'm going to have church, even if I got to have it right by myself. Amen. The world can make make you bitter and cold, but God will make you better and warm. Hello, somebody. But God, I'm glad y'all have had a but God moment. Amen. When God turned everything, listen, our life was in a mudslide headed downhill. Oh, but God, He showed up and He rescued us one more time. Hey, even after we've been to an altar and we prayed and we had supplication with God and we know that we've been saved, ain't no way the devil can take my name out of the Lamb's Book of Life. But I still have moments when I want to look at the flesh and turn to the flesh. As long as we're in this world, that temptation, it's going to be there. But I'm glad that at the end of today, we can have a but God moment, amen, and He can melt away the cares and take away the things that burden you down and make you bitter in your life. But God. But God. Well, we learned about little Grinch. So Grinch began to grow a little bit older, amen. As an older man, he retreated over to Mount Crumpet, where he resided right by himself. He had his bait with people, amen. I can relate to Brother Grinch, amen. There's times in my life when I just don't like people. Hello, somebody. Especially when I go to Walmart or get stuck on 485 in rush hour traffic. There's times when I just look at the ignorance of people around me and say, my God, give them some sense because I can't handle this anymore. People will drive you to your outer limits. Grinch would have grown up in a town friendly and loving people, but people happened. The more I learn about people, the more I love my dogs. Hello, somebody. But preacher, you said your dog has bit you. I still love him more, because I know where he stands at. Hello, somebody. My dog bit me while I was looking at him. He didn't bite me in the back. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. Oh, even in the Baptist church, you better believe it, honey. Whenever you come amongst a group of people and you let envy and strife begin to set into the hearts of people, and that green monster of jealousy begins to arise, people will start shooting you in the back. Hello. Stick the knife in you and twist it. Hello, somebody. We got two options. We'll either let it affect us, or we can become like a duck and let the water roll right off our back. Hello. The devil is going to try his best to ride with everybody. It's up to you whether you put the saddle on or not. Come on, y'all. Back in my cowboy days, there was two types of cowboys. Ones that been throwed and the ones that ain't yet. Hello. But their day was coming. Because they had a horse that can't be rode. But they had a cowboy that can't be throwed. Hello. It's easier to ride a horse if you got a saddle to sit in. It's a lot harder if he's bareback than you just hanging on to his mane. Hello, somebody. I don't know why so many people in the church house want to put a saddle on their back and tell the devil to jump in and ride. Hey, I'm going to be as barebacked as I can get. I even shaved my mane off. He ain't got nothing to hold on to no more. I'm a buck and I'm a kick. I'm a roll over. I'm a jump up and down. I'm a try everything every day to get the devil off of my back. Amen. I don't want him to go home with me at night. I don't want him to ride with me in the daytime. I don't want that joker nowhere around me. I'm going to take the saddle off. Amen. And I'm going to kick him in the teeth every time I get a chance. Amen. When I stand up of a morning and I look out the window and I see the devil standing out there just a glaring, waiting on me to come out the door. I walk out the door. I pull open my shirt and I greater is He that is in me than he that is in this world. Amen. We all going to have situations in life. It's all according to how you handle those situations. that separate us from the rest of the world. Hello, somebody. Our next character that we see in the Grinch movie is little Cindy Lou Who. Well, Cindy Lou, she was a child. Hello. Had innocence. She was an innocent little child. And she had love for the unlovable. If we've ever seen the grace of God and a character on a movie screen, it was Cindy Lou Who. She began to hear about the festival and the competition for the holiday. Something Meister. The Whoville Holiday Cheermeister. Here you go. Somebody watched a movie. As Grinch would say, the holiday Whoobie Waddy. The holiday Whoobie Waddy. And he said, if I won, then somebody had to lose. Right? That's what he said. Cindy Lou let him believe anything he wanted to believe just to get him to come to town. Hello, somebody. That's why we need to paint the church house as a perfected place that people want to come be a part of. Is it perfect? No, it's not perfect. We are not perfect, and we're not going to be perfect until we get to heaven. But we got to paint that portrait to this world and let them see, look, even though we're an imperfect people, we serve a perfect God. Yes, Cindy Lou loved the Grinch unconditionally. Even though she stories about how mean he was. I don't really think the Grinch was that mean, but he was just misunderstood. Hello? I'm not really a mean person, Brother Willie. I'm just misunderstood sometimes. But I'm going to promise you this, you won't ever have to wonder what side of the fence I'm on. I don't like playing games, amen? I'm going to be as straightforward and to the point as I can possibly be. And some people just can't take that sometimes. I'm just misunderstood. But I love unconditionally. I love people with all my heart, I do. Even though people have done me wrong, I still try to find the forgiveness of the Lord Jesus Christ in me. And forgive them and show them unconditional love. Where would we be today had we not felt and experienced the unconditional love of the Lord Jesus Christ? We would be just as bad as Mr. Grinch. Play my soft music, David. Not my grand finale music, but my soft music. I got a grand finale. Where would we be today if we hadn't experienced unconditional love of the Father? Cindy Lou climbed Mount Crumpet just to take the Grinch an invitation to the party. Y'all remember? We watched that movie in here last year, y'all. We did. And you say, well, where do you find Jesus in all of that? My Lord climbed a hill too. It wasn't Mount Crumpet. It was Calvary. And he climbed that hill just to give you and me an invitation. And it was because he had for you and for me. Did the Grinch change when he got the invitation? No. He went on and done even worser things than he'd ever done before. Hello. I don't want nobody to raise their hand and say, preacher, that was me. I can almost raise my hand and say, that was me too. There was a time in my life when I got mad at God. I did. And the things I was experiencing, Brother Willie, wasn't even his fault. It was people. But I let them people influence me so much that I got mad at God. And if there was anything I knew that God wanted to do, an exact opposite. I wanted to see just how far away from Him that I could get. I said, "Preacher, why in the world would you tell us that as a pastor of this church?" Because my story don't stop there. But God saw fit to invite me one more time. God saw fit to love me one more time. God saw fit to love me one more time. Man, the Grinch went down and he stole everything away from the Grinches. He stole away their Christmas trees and their presents. And the story says he even took their last can of hoo hash. Left crumbs wasn't even big enough for a mouse. And you say, "Well, Brother Jeremy, how does that relate to me?" Man, I'm here to tell you that the devil's took way more away from you than you could ever imagine. Some of you, he's disturbed your sleep. Some of you, he's taken your joy. Some of you, he's taken away your desire to even interact with people. The devil has taken away way more than what you'll ever realize. The Bible says that his job is to kill, steal, and destroy. What's he want to kill? Us. The legacy of the Lord Jesus Christ. What's he want to steal? Your joy. The Word of God. The love that's in your heart. He wants to steal those things and destroy every bit of your life that you spent so much time building up. Some people can raise up against you with their mouth and their tongue, and they'll speak evilness against you, and they can tear down in 10 minutes what it took you 10 years to build. The tongue is a powerful member. Sometimes you can't even control it. So the Grinch had a "but God" moment in his life. He experienced the love of people even though he was unlovable. He finally felt what it felt like to be loved. He said it's not in packages or bows. It's not in tinsel and string. He said Christmas can't be bought at a store. Perhaps it really is much more. Do you know today that salvation can't be bought? Aren't you glad that man can't put price on salvation? If man put price on salvation, I don't know that even we could afford it. But it's free to the whosoever that'll call upon the name of the Lord. They'll be saved. That's a "but God" moment. When the Grinch finally seen that joy didn't come from the Christmas tree or the lights or the packages or the hoo feast that they were about to have. Joy came by people coming together. Come here, Kyle. Brother Willie. Brother Joe. Sister Debbie. Brother Michael. Brother Jerry. Brother Jeff, Brother James, Brother Marty, Sister April. Let's make us a circle right over here. Hit it, Dave. Make a circle. Make a circle. Circles around, people. Circles around. That's how it is. Listen, we got to do this. Yahoo, blah, 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 blah. Y'all remember how to move? Who is Dorothy? Who is Dorothy? Blah, 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 Christmas Day. So joy comes when people come together in heavenly. Joy comes from. Y'all ain't had this on Christmas. I can tell by the looks on your face. Even look back there, they laugh. Man, that's good stuff. Okay, that's enough. Everybody go back to sleep. The Grinch said, I'm leaking. What's the deal? I feel all warm and fuzzy inside. I'm leaking. What's the deal? Glad that somebody showed you love. Confederate Railroad said there's two people that always loved us. It was Jesus and Mama. Amen. That's a fact with my hand up. I know for a fact there was many, many nights that my mama laid and prayed for me. That you would find in your life that but God moment. And Jesus, climbed that hill of Calvary, and gave his life as a ransom, that his blood would allow you to experience a but God moment. I guess in all you could say that I found Jesus by watching The Grinch. I seen Jesus in that movie. Because just like the Grinch, I was lost in the trespasses of my sin. But God. And I felt that warm, fuzzy feeling down in my heart. And it grew that day. My heart grew that day. My love for people grew that day. My compassion and understanding for the sinner, it grew that day. And I have never been the same. I've been forever changed from the creature I once was to the person I am today because of God and His marvelous grace. I wonder today, with every head bowed and every eye closed, is there anybody in here today that say, Brother Jeremy, pray for me? I,